This is an MCP 5-minute moment brought to you by the Massachusetts Department of Environmental Protection's Bureau of Wayside Cleanup. My name is Paul Locke. In 1983, Massachusetts adopted General Law Chapter 21E, which authorized the Department of Environmental Protection to write regulations detailing how to identify, evaluate, and clean up hazardous waste sites. These regulations are known as the MCP, which stands for the Massachusetts Contingency Plan. Since then, over 44,000 releases of oil or hazardous material have been reported to DEP, and the majority of them have been cleaned up in a timely manner. Some sites, however, have lingered in the system, not because they're technically complex, but because there is no viable, responsible party to actually conduct the cleanup. There's nobody willing or able to do the work. That's where the Brownfields Program can help. The term brownfield was coined to describe properties with a history of past use, typically industrial or commercial use, that may have resulted in environmental contamination. The opposite of brownfield would be greenfield, a previously unused and assumed to be pristine property with no hidden environmental surprises. Brownfield sites are often abandoned properties lacking financially viable owners. These are the underutilized or blighted locations in your community, the former gas stations, the shuttered mills, or the derelict factories. Before these properties can be redeveloped, an expensive environmental assessment and cleanup may be necessary, and these unknown costs often deter potential developers. Instead, they frequently turn to greenfields for projects. So how can Massachusetts facilitate the cleanup and redevelopment of these sites? In 1998, the state passed the Brownfields Act, establishing a number of incentives for people to clean up and reuse contaminated property, recognizing that the benefits of reusing a brownfield go well beyond the environmental improvements. By coordinating cleanup and redevelopment, investing in a brownfield can create new jobs, increase local taxes, make use of existing infrastructure, and reduce development pressure on open land. The Act provides both liability relief and financial resources to encourage new investment. The Brownfield Act created liability protections for new parties undertaking cleanups once they achieve certain specific cleanup endpoints. These protections allow developers to better estimate the financial risk associated with the project. Massachusetts also has a Brownfield Covenant Not to Sue program administered by the Office of the Attorney General. Through this program, the Commonwealth may enter into agreements that provide liability protection to current or prospective owners and may also be available to causally responsible parties. The Covenant Not to Sue program is intended to provide additional incentives for cleanup and reuse of complex or difficult sites where redevelopment would not otherwise be possible. The 1998 Brownfields Act also created a number of financial incentives that are implemented by MassDEP's sister agencies. MassDevelopment administers a redevelopment fund with both loans and grants for brownfields assessment and cleanup in environmentally distressed areas. The Massachusetts Department of Revenue offers brownfields tax credits for up to 50% of remediation costs for eligible projects. And the Department of Energy Resources offers energy-related tax credits for solar reuse of brownfield sites. The success of these incentives means that the money available for the Brownfields Redevelopment Fund and subsidized environmental insurance depends upon periodic recapitalization of the funds. Applicants should check with the administering agencies to determine current resource availability. MassDEP's primary role in brownfield projects is to provide technical assistance. The department has staff available to meet with local municipalities and potential developers, including a statewide brownfields coordinator located in DEP's Boston office and specific contacts in each of our 4 regional offices. The brownfield staff can help guide you through the state's semi-privatized wastesite cleanup program, in which authorized contractors, known as licensed site professionals or LSPs, oversee and sign off on most aspects of a cleanup. The use of LSPs allows work at sites to proceed without waiting for DEP approval at each step, which greatly streamlines the process. DEP has also adopted risk-based standards, which allow parties to consider the future planned use of a site during cleanup. For example, a property that will be used for a self-storage facility would not need to meet the stricter residential use standards. A land use restriction, called an activity and use limitation, may be part of an overall cleanup. MassDEP does not oversee all phases of the site cleanup process. The department focuses its resources on providing technical assistance, auditing the work overseen by LSPs, and coordinating with state and federal agencies. Since passage of the 1998 Brownfields Act, MassDEP, along with state and federal partners, has assisted with hundreds of brownfields projects, resulting in the successful redevelopment of old contaminated sites. Brownfield projects can be complex and involve factors that go beyond site cleanup, including unique marketing and funding strategies. The Brownfields Program offers municipalities, community development organizations, and private developers incentives to convert these contaminated properties into productive uses, creating jobs and economic opportunities. Since these old sites are often close to rail lines, transportation hubs, utilities, and population centers, the reuse of brownfield sites promotes smart growth by revitalizing blighted urban areas, supporting local economic growth, and advancing environmental health. For more information on the Massachusetts Brownfields Program, please visit MassDEP at www.mass.gov/DEP.